Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. But on Saturday, SpaceX did back-to-back launches, starting with their 31st mission of the year with the launch of Utelsat 36D.
Mission and liftoff of Falcon 9. Go Utelsat, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1072, then landed successfully for the 12th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Nominal parking orbit.
Landing light deploy.
A few hours later and SpaceX successfully launched their 32nd mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 645.
One, ignition, and liftoff of Starlink 645. Go SpaceX, go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1067, then landed successfully for the 18th time on the drone ship in shortfall of gravitas.
Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Then, on Tuesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 33rd mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 718.
1, ignition. And liftoff of Falcon 9. Go Starlink, go SpaceX.
The booster which launched this mission, B1071, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
There are a couple of Starlink missions scheduled for this week. The first of these, the Starlink 647 mission, is currently scheduled for Friday 5th at 6:14 a.m. UTC or 2:14 a.m. EST. The following day, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink launch. The Starlink 81 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 6th at 2:25 a.m. UTC or Friday 5th at 10:25 p.m. EST. The following day, and we can hopefully expect to see another mission launch. The Bandwagon 1 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 7th at 11:17 p.m. UTC or 7:17 p.m. EST. Then, going into next week, we can hopefully expect to see another Starlink mission. The Starlink 648 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday 9th at 10:14 p.m. UTC or 6:14 p.m. EST. Related to the Utelsat launch, SpaceX posted information about the landing. They said Falcon 9 lands on Just Read the Instructions drone ship, completing our 30th launch and landing of the year and 325th successful Falcon launch overall. Prior to the two launches on Saturday that were supposed to be free, SpaceX posted saying free flight-proven Falcon 9 boosters vertical ahead of today's launches from Florida and California. In response, they also said 7 years ago today, Falcon 9 launched SES-10, marking the first reflight of an Orbital class first stage booster. There was an article posted with information about SpaceX being denied access to spectrum bands for Starlink. It says, Starlink's mobile ambitions were dealt at least a temporary blow yesterday when the Federal Communications Commission dismissed SpaceX's application to use several spectrum bands for mobile service. Heading to Boca Chica, here's a view of the orbital launch pad. A crane has been spotted at the site where they are building the new Starbase office. Work continues on the construction of the new office building. Work also continues on the expansion of Star Factory. This new part was spotted near the production site. Related to what we saw in last week's video from NSF's Alex with a leg of the orbital launch mount at KSC being demolished, more have fallen. He said, 4 down, 2 more to go. After Ship 29's full 6-engine static fire we saw earlier last week, SpaceX posted this video saying static fire of a single Raptor engine using the header tanks on Flight 4 Starship. After the single engine static fire, Starship 29 was hooked up to the crane. Ship 29 was then lifted off of the Pad B test mount. Ship 29 was then rolled back to the production site and into the high bay for some further work in preparation for Flight 4. Musk posted some information about the goal for Flight 4. He said, getting ready for Flight 4 of Starship. Goal of this mission is for Starship to get through max re-entry heating with all systems functioning. Taking a look at the Cameron County website, there is currently a closure scheduled for Friday 5th. Additionally, there is a closure scheduled for today, Wednesday 3rd, for hopefully Booster 11 rollout. To finish up the video today, we have an updated Starship production diagram to take a look at thanks to the Ring Watchers. In addition to that, of course, we also have a booster production diagram to take a look at as well. As always, I have to say thanks to both Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, and Sean Doherty for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams, and other space content. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.